Hello, here we are. This is the end of season awards. You can see that Vasco Madeira was the player of the season. The goal of the season was Oliver Burke against Red Bull Salzburg. Let's watch that goal. I don't remember it. I have no memory about it, so let's see how it was. Oh, it's from a corner. Okay, and then boom. It's a good shot. It's a good shot, yeah. Then Jean Guillou was the signing of the season for 13.4 millions, and the young player of the season is Vasco Madeira. Okay, the season review. We finished 7 in the Premier Division. We lost in the 6th round of the FA Cup. We lost in the semi-final of the Euro Cup, and we won the Capital One Cup, which is not bad, not bad at all. This is the team of 2015 where they are. I'm not going to go through that. This I don't want to see also. The injuries, we had some injuries, not really very complicated. They were more to the end of the season, so that's that. Okay, anyway, let's start having a look at the squad. As you can see, we still have Draxler and Costa. They are okay-ish. Costa has a bit more potential, so I am thinking I'll be letting Draxler go and maybe giving finally an opportunity to Lokoi. See if Lokoi can reach his potential or not. Maybe I'll be doing that. Then on the right side we have Madeira, great player. José Carlos, he is good, he is okay. On the left we have Guillot, a great player, and we have also Dicu, who is okay-ish. Then as a centre back we have Chalobah. He looks not that good. Then Iacovitti is okay-ish, Lindstrom is okay-ish, and Kongolo is also not that great. We have here Yacine El Amdawi, which I think has to play one more year on the under-21s, and then he will be ready for the first team. So I'll probably be looking into signing some centre back for the next season, at least one. As a center midfield position, we have Seong and Flynn, who are good players. And then we have also here Peter Müller, who has tons of potential, but he should be playing still on the under-18s or 21s. Then for the right position, we have Burke, which is an okay player, and we have Luís Souza, which has tons of potential, so I'm going to keep trying Luis Souza a bit. And I think I don't have, no, I don't have anyone else. Then for the left side we have Gribin, a good player, and Dolan. Dolan is becoming a good player also, so we are okay there. For the attacking midfield, we have Dauch, which is a good player, and we have Murphy, which is a bit meh. I think it's probably the last season from Murphy because I think I have someone already signed for this position. So Murphy is probably going to say goodbye. And we also have on the under-21s, we have Jordi Soler. Which is going to keep playing on the under-21s one more season, and then he'll be ready, and then he'll be ready for the first team. We also have Rodolfo Ferreira, but Rodolfo Ferreira, I don't think he's going anywhere. And we have also Gary Perrier, but Gary Perrier, I think he's not going anywhere also. Then on the attack, we have Neal, a bit meh, but with potential. We have Laurent, a good player. Cassul, a good player. Moro, a bit meh. And Nuno Delgado, who is probably going to keep playing for the under-21s one more season, probably. We will see. We will see how this will go. Anyway, if we gonna look at the stats, we can see that Drexler and Costa did pretty much almost the same games. Drexler played slightly better. Then on the right side, Madeira played amazingly, 13 assists. José Carlos, 9 assists, played also good. On the left, Guillot played very well, 7 assists. Dico came in, did 3 assists. He is an okay player. Center back, Chalobah, actually plays quite well. So, Jakovic also plays well. Lindstrom, bit meh, and Kongolo, he also plays quite well. So, we will see what will happen there. Yam Dawi had no games for the first team. Yam Dawi was playing mainly for the under-18s and playing well and progressing well as a player. Well, then on the center midfield position, we had Flynn and Seong here. Both played a bit. Flynn scored one goal and did more assists, and he played generally a little bit better than Seong. Though Flynn does much more fouls, he sees more yellow cards, but then Seong sees more red cards. It's balanced. On the right wing, Sousa actually played okay. 2 goals, 3 assists. He didn't play many games. Burke, amazing, 19 goals, 10 assists, played very well. On the left, we had Dolan, 17 goals, 9 assists, playing very well. And we had Gribin, 9 goals, 18 assists, playing even better. So our left was great. Then, as attacking midfield, John Murphy was a bit meh, 2 goals, 7 assists. And Dauch was better, with 10 goals, 2 assists, was a bit better. On the attack, we had Neil scoring 19 goals. Quite good, playing well. Laurent scored only 8 goals, played a bit meh. Cassul, amazing, scored 22 goals, played very well. And Moro scored 11 goals, he played well, Moro. Yeah, Delgado, he managed to play a bit, but he didn't score. There's that. And Peter Müller also had his first appearance, but nothing special. So this was it. I'm looking forward for the next season. Also, something I want to show you is that we have another improvement on training facilities and on youth facilities. Both are scheduled to be ready around October. If you are curious, our facilities are now training impressive and youth good. So, with these improvements, we should really start to get top training facilities and very good youth facilities. Transfer wise, we have a couple of players here. We have. I can tell you that Ofosu, this is the attacking midfielder. So that's why I was saying that Murphy is probably going to be sold or sent to the under-21s. Ricardo Torres is a striker, and Jean-Pierre Denis, he is a very young left mid. So we will see how they will fit. I am also going to be looking, as I told you, for a center back. And that's more or less how things are. I would also like to find maybe another right mid, because Burke is not very young. So we will see. We will see. Anyway, see you next season. Bye.